In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ, today in the first reading we hear that cup that we bless is a sign of our communion in the blood of Christ. The bread that we bless is a communion with the body of Christ. Though one bread, though we are many, we are one in that one bread, one in Jesus Christ. For the times we have failed to be one in this flock of Jesus. For the times we have failed to bring unity in this fold of Christ, let us ask pardon from the Lord. With contrite hearts, let's say together, I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, by whom we are redeemed and receive adoption, look graciously upon your beloved sons and daughters, that those who believe in Christ may receive true freedom and an everlasting inheritance. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. My beloved, flee from idolatry. I speak as to sensible people. Judge for yourselves what I say. The cup of blessing that we bless, is it not a participation in the blood of Christ? The bread that we break, is it not a participation in the body of Christ? Because there is one bread. We who are many are one body, for we all partake of the one bread. Consider the people of Israel. Are not those who eat the sacrifices participants in the altar? What do I imply then? The food offered to idols is anything, or that an idol is anything? No, I imply that what pagans sacrifice, they offer to demons and not to God. I do not want you to be the participants with demons. You cannot drink the cup of the Lord and the cup of demons. You cannot partake the table of the Lord and the table of demons. Shall we provoke the Lord to jealousy? Are we stronger than He? The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let our response be, a thanksgiving sacrifice I make to you, O Lord. Please repeat.
A thanksgiving sacrifice I make to you, O Lord.
How can I repay the Lord for all His goodness to me? The cups of salvation I will raise. I will call on the name of the Lord. Your response.
A thanksgiving sacrifice I make to you, O Lord.
A thanksgiving sacrifice I make. I will call on the name of the Lord. My vows to the Lord I will fulfill before all His people. Your response.
A thanksgiving sacrifice I make to you, O Lord.
Kindly rise for the gospel. Alleluia, alleluia. If anyone loves me, he will keep my word, says the Lord. And my Father will love him, and we will come to him. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
At that time, Jesus said to his disciples, No good tree bears bad fruit, nor again does a bad tree bear good fruit. For each tree is known by its own fruit. For figs are not gathered from thorn bushes, nor are grapes picked from a bramble bush. The good person out of the good treasure of his heart produces good, and the evil person out of his evil treasure produces evil. For out of the abundance of the heart his mouth speaks. Why do you call me Lord, Lord, and not do what I tell you? Everyone who comes to me and hears my words and does them, I will show you what he is like. He is like a man building a house who dug deep and laid the foundation on the rock. And when a flood arose, the stream broke against the house and could not shake it because it had been well built. But the one who hears and does not do them is like a man who built a house on the ground without a foundation. When the stream broke against it, immediately it fell, and the ruin of that house was great. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ, imagine you are holding a cup of coffee when someone comes along and bumps into you and shakes your arm, making you spill your coffee everywhere. Now the question is, why did you spill the coffee? Obviously, the answer would be, someone bumped into you. But the answer is wrong. You spilled the coffee because there was coffee in your cup. Had there been tea in the cup, you would have spilled tea. Whatever is inside the cup is what you spill out. That's what we hear in the gospel today. Out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks. A good tree produces good fruits, and the bad tree produces bad fruit. Whatever you are from within, that is reflected in your life, in your words, in your deeds. So we have to ask ourselves, what is in my cup? When life gets tough, what spills over? Joy, gratefulness, peace, humility, or anger, bitterness, harsh words, and reactions. What is in my cup? My dear brothers and sisters, the life provides the cup, and we choose what to fill in it. The filling part is left on us. That is our freedom. We choose what to fill in it. If you fill good things, we have good things to spill over. If we fill bad things, we are left with only the bad things to spill over. I would like to suggest four things that are very much necessary for us to bear good fruits in our lives. If our house has to stand firm on the foundation that is laid by this Mother Church, we need to have these four things. First of all, to bear good fruits, we need to prune the plant of life. We need the pruning. Without the pruning, we cannot have good fruits from this plant of life. How can you do this pruning? This pruning can happen in my life through a confession, through the spiritual direction, from the guidance of the teachers, from the guidance of the counselor. We need pruning now and then. That pruning helps us to produce better fruits in our lives. We produce fruits, but to have those better fruits, we need that pruning. The second thing that is needed for the plant of life is the manuring. Without the manuring, the plant does not grow well and the plant cannot produce good fruits. However good the plant is, it needs manuring. It needs nourishment. And how do we manure the plant of life? We manure the plant of life through sacraments, through the word of God, through the reading of holy books, spiritual books, listening to positive vibes. This is how we try to nourish the plant of life. What's the third thing that is necessary? We need a gardener. When you speak of pruning, when you speak of manuring, it speaks of another person. So that is a gardener. We need a gardener for the plant of life, for the plant of our life. That, who is that gardener? It could be our elders, our parents, our teachers. It could be our confessor, spiritual director, counselor. These are the gardeners who come into our lives so that our life becomes meaningful. Our life has a direction. Our plant goes in the right direction, in the right manner. And finally, my dear brothers and sisters, we need time. Time on ourselves. To spend time on ourselves, to build our life, to build this plant of life so that it can bear good fruit. Let us invest some time on us. Invest some time so that we can get into this pruning, we can get into this manuring, we can get in touch with the gardener. These four things that are necessary so that we bear good fruit is also applicable to the other allegory that we hear in the gospel today, building the house on the rock. If you want to build your house on the rock, these are the things that are needed. Maybe a helper from out who can give us the direction, who can help us to go deeper into our lives. And this certainly the sacraments. Now we are here around this altar to celebrate this Eucharist. Let us ask the Lord in a very special way. Lord, help us so that we can prune our life, so that we can prune the plant of our life so that it can bear good fruit, so that we may fill good things into our lives, so that we can spill over good things. May the Eucharistic Lord help us, because the Mother Church has given this sacrament into our lives, for our lives, so that we bear good fruit in the society. May this Eucharist help us. May the word of God that we have heard today help us to bear good fruit in this society and permeate the love of Christ. Amen. Pray, my dear brethren, that the sacrifice you and me offer here on this altar may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
O God, who graciously accomplished the effects of your mysteries, grant, we pray, that the deeds by which we serve you may be worthy of the sacred gifts, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, to praise your mighty deeds in the exaltation of all the saints, and especially as we celebrate the memory of the Blessed Virgin Mary, to proclaim your kindness as we echo her thankful hymn of praise. For truly, even to us ends, you have done great things and extend your abundant mercy from age to age. When you looked on the lowliness of your handmaid, you gave us through her the author of salvation, your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Through him the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim,
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it. He gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Philip Neri our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles, with Saint Joseph, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coerced to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen.
Asking the help from the Lord so that we take care of our plant of our life, let us pray the prayer taught by Jesus himself. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from all evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace be with you.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Behold him who invites us to bear good fruit in our lives. Happy are we who are called to the supper of this Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
As we receive this heavenly sacrament, we beseech you, O Lord, your mercy, that we who rejoice in commemorating the Blessed Virgin Mary, may by imitating her, serve worthily the mystery of our redemption, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Let us go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Have a nice day, all of you.
God is good. Good.